Hi, I'm Wade Wingler with the INDATA project at Easter Seals Crossroads in Indiana. Today we're going to talk about something that isn't exactly assistive technology, but can be used that way. We're going to talk about parental controls on Macintosh computers. So we're here on an iMac right now, and I'm going to click down here on System Preferences, and we're going to talk a little bit about parental controls. Parental controls are set up to allow you to restrict the time or the way that a computer is accessed. And there are a lot of reasons where that might be appropriate. Folks who have certain kinds of disabilities, like autism or cognitive delays, may benefit from a computer environment that's a little more controlled, doesn't have as many options. So here's what we're going to do. We're on a regular Mac OS X operating system here. This happens to be Snow Leopard, which is so far the latest version. And I've opened up the System Preferences. I click down here on the gears. I go up to Accounts, and the first thing I need to do is start a new account. So I'm going to unlock right here, which will allow me to create a new user account. And it's going to ask me for my password. And that verifies that somebody who has administrative options on this computer is creating the account. And then I'm going to give the account a name here. We're going to call it Nicole because that's the name of the person we want to restrict their access. And I'm going to tell it to create an account. You can choose whether you want it to automatically log in or not. For these purposes, we're going to leave it on automatic login. Now you'll notice when we start a new account here, we have the name, we have an icon, and there's an option here to check to click and enable parental controls, and that's what we want to do. So I'm going to click on open parental controls, and then you see the options that we have here. The first thing is to use the simple finder, and when you do that, it's going to make changes and only allow certain access to the computer. It's going to provide a very simplified view of the computer. So you can check that, and it'll really take all the things that are down along the bottom down here in your taskbar and reduce the number of things that are down there. You can also limit the applications that the person's allowed to use. So you can tell them whether they do have access to the App Store or not. So there's a lot of ways to modify the amount of applications or the number of applications the person can do. You can also tell it down here whether or not the person can modify the dock. So all these icons down here, whether they can add to or remove things from there. So that the first section here under apps allows you to change the overall appearance of your operating system. The next one is about websites, and this is really important if you need to restrict the number of websites or the kinds of websites that folks are going to. So you have the option of allow unrestricted access to websites, so you can go to anything. You've also got the option to only allow access to certain websites, and this is a list of generally kid-friendly websites, but you can go down here and click on the plus and you can add websites so that you can only allow certain kind of content, very specific websites. And then there's kind of an in-between option here that allows you to customize, and you can say always allow these websites and you can add those as you want, or never allow these websites and you can restrict websites, and it also does some guessing about what should and shouldn't be allowed. So I would encourage you to play around with these settings and figure out what kind of access is appropriate. There are also options here to limit the people that can be emailed, the people who can be involved in iChat applications. You can also, when you limit email, if the user tries to send an email to somebody who's not on the approved list, you can tell it to always send an email request to a parent or somebody who's administrating the computer to decide whether or not a person should be allowed on the list. So this is a place here either under chat or email where you can add contacts that are sort of whitelisted or allowed to be used. This is one of my favorite areas. This is time limits, and you have weekday time limits, weekend time limits, and you can set a bedtime. So you can say, limit the computer to 3 hours a day during the week, 5 hours a day on the weekends, and on school night, after 8 o'clock to 6 a.m., no use of the computer. And on the weekend, maybe after 9 o'clock until 6 a.m., there's no access to the computer. And that prevents somebody during the nighttime hours from accessing the computer. Very handy options there. The last thing here are some interesting things about hiding the profanity in the dictionary. Apple computers have a dictionary built in. You can check this box and turn off the cuss words. You can also limit printer administration, limit the ability to burn CDs and DVDs, also limit the ability to change the password. So although not exclusively an assistive technology program, this is a very useful tool built into the Apple product to allow people to have a more controlled computer experience. So that's your tech tip for this week. I'm Wade Wingler with the INDATA project in Indiana.